Hey guys, and welcome to the new series, which is the game Evil Islands. I've played this on my channel once before, I think. And recently it's started to get a lot more popularity, so I thought, well, people want to see this. So I decided, let's do this for another series and alternate between the two. Now, I know that the difficulty says novice and normal. However... I think this was originally, a Russian release? Like, this game is a lot more popular in Asia than it is here in North America. There was a patch for this game released in Asia that wasn't around for North America. And I think these difficulty settings are, in fact, wrong. Because, the translations are pretty good. The voice acting's not, but... I'm gonna go on novice, because normal is very difficult. So. Oh, nope. Skip cutscenes. You cannot show cutscenes of games.
I woke up and could not remember anything.
Oh. Hold on. Got it. I forgot. This game does not, like you right-click to change the camera, but if you go up and down, I'm gonna hardly move the mouse. Instantly. And you can't even, if you go to options, camera, wait, nope, sensitivity, there it is. Yeah. Mouse sensitivity. Scrolling, right there. That's half sensitivity for scrolling. Oh no, scrolling is actually side to side. Mouse sensitivity is the one. But, yeah. Not fun. So, what I'm doing to reset it is I'm pressing the F10 key. F11. Yeah, there we go. Oh, that took a screenshot. Okay, good to know. Alright. So, left click... No, let's go F10. I like this one better. So, left click to move. Let's turn carefully. Hi, people! Bye.
Yes.
Let's go.
Yes.
Me and my clothes. And it looks like a tattoo on my chest.
Oh,
I got hit. Took a bit of damage from that. Let's heal. So in this game, you have the ability to aim at different parts of the body.
Yes.
So if I were to go down here, what I can do is I can walk up to this guy using the number pad. I can aim for different parts of the body, which I think is a very good feature. I'm just going to aim for the body. The body is the easiest part to hit, but it has the most health. So how it works is if we go here, we can see that different parts of our body have different hit points.
Yes.
It will not show you exact numbers, but how it works is that the body has 100% of your hit points, the head has 100% of your hit points, and the arms and the legs each have 49% each, I think. Now, you might be thinking, well, that's almost 400 or 500%. How is that even possible? Because it works in the sense that you have a total health bar here. If it gets to zero, you're dead. So if you lose a leg and an arm, you'll be left with like 1 or 2% of your health.
Yes.
And then you're not going to be able to do much. But then if you also get hit in the leg, the left leg and the left arm are both broken and out of hit points. If you get hit in the right leg, you can then die. Which is not good. Don't die. Dying is bad. If you die, you just start over. Whoa, that crit, though. So, I'm going to use this spell. There we go. In story mode, you start off with a few spells. The way these things work is that if you lose all of the hit points in one leg, or two legs, then your speed is massively cut. You cannot walk or run. You cannot run at all. If your leg is broken, you cannot. Oh, heal. With a broken leg, it is impossible to run. If you run, you go a lot faster. So here, there's walking, running.
Yes.
You go a lot faster. But I gotta be more careful because my stamina is also my kind of mana bar for casting spells. So let's go up here. Oh, there's a wolf. Hi, Wolfie. So yeah, losing a leg, I think, cuts your speed in half, and you can only walk. I don't think you can crouch or crawl at all. Oh shoot, and my arm is under half health. That means that my actions are reduced. What your actions are basically how many things you can do. I think it's in a minute. Yeah, because my actions are 8 right now. Actions is, well, the number of actions you can take. I think it's in... I'm not sure the amount of time. I think probably it's either 30 seconds or a minute. So if I heal... There we go. Now I have 16 actions. Because my arm is not under half health. Which is what I was about to explain before it happened. Talk about timing. If your arm gets to half health or less... Well, the same for leg. If it gets to half health or less, then you get slowed down. If your arm gets to half health or less, your actions get reduced, which means you can't cast spells as fast, and you can't attack as fast.
Done.
Let's sneak up on this guy. Bam! I got a backstab multiplier. I think a backstab is double damage. So if you can get into an enemy's blind spot...
Yes.
And you can hit them without them noticing you. Then you get a 200% damage multiplier or double damage. You can also aim for the head, and if you get go to the village. Okay, if you hit the head, it's a critical hit, which I think does 3 times damage. I think. Also, these multipliers stack. So if you get a backstab headshot, which would be a backstab critical, you do 6 times damage to enemies. What is that? Oh, that's an ogre. Let's not try to fight him. That's a bad idea. We can kill this wolf, though.
Excellent.
Oh, well, that's not too close to the ogre. It's not. Okay, good. Oh, there goes my arm. Dang it. That's a good strategy. He's got 3 health? Oh, no, we can just hit him. There we go. If you don't choose what to target on the enemy, then it'll go through a random number generator or a random hit thing, and it'll hit different parts of them randomly. Let's crawl. I don't think we can get that past this guy without crawling. It's really slow, but I don't want to be seen by that guy. There we go.
Yes.
There, I think we're good then. I don't see anyone else. Oh, that's another
yes.
one. Oh, you know what? We can probably steal from this guy. S click.
Very slowly.
Oh, we stole 84 gold. Nice.
Excellent.
Okay, you know what? We're gonna go I'm gonna save here just in case. Gonna call it. There, we're gonna save that. There. Because I know there's another ogre over here, and I want to steal from him too. Oh, he's turning. If an enemy is turning like this,
yes.
that also increases, or that changes their FOV, or their field of vision. So you have to be very careful if they're turning like that. But I think I can get behind this guy. I'll have to go about here.
Yes.
And steal.
Gently.
Nice. Another 98 money. Well, it's not really. I guess it's not gold.
Yes.
It's just money. Another 98 M's.
Just
I'm just going to refer to it as gold. It's easier. Another 98 gold. Well, that's good. Can't steal from the first guy, though, because I can't get behind him. Okay, if I go further down, I should be able to walk. There we go. I should be able to walk now. There we go. And then go across the bridge. There we go. That shiny area is the village. That's where I'm trying to get to. Let's go for a backstab critical on this guy. Can we get his friend? Oh, nice. Normally what would happen there is I think one of them would turn around as soon as their friend died. But that's just kind of a training thing to like, oh, it won't. Now you can know how to do it. Hold on. I'm going to go into the village soon. Let's fast forward this part, though, because it's going to take a little while.
Done.
There, and we're back. Let's go into the village. Do you want to leave the game zone? Yes. Now we load. Cool. Oh. There we go. Auto move. I didn't click anything. Can I click away? I can't. Hi, Cawdor the Rowdy. Arfar the Silver Tongue.
Oh dear. Looks like the whole village is here.
Right. Everyone here. Quiet now. The Elder is going to speak.
My people, today is a great day for our village. We all remember the legend about the Chosen One, who
Okay, so basically what happened is, let's just skip that, I can summarize it. What happened is, the people who you were praying at the village live here, they were praying at the shrine. They saw you, and they went back here, and they're like, oh, he's the Chosen One, he's the prophecy, he's like, oh, he's gonna defend our people, and save us from all the trouble we're in, and then it's like, oh, if he is the Chosen, he'll get the best food, the best shelter, praise, adoration, all this stuff, and then the main character's like, oh, that sounds great, let's do it. But it's like, yeah, but he's our protector and he'll defend us from all this stuff. He's like, oh, maybe I should just say I'm not the guy. And like, he's just thinking this. And then this guy's like, but if he's an imposter, what would we do? Oh, we just throw him in the fire pit right here. And he's like, yeah, I'm the Chosen. You can call me Zach.
Listen, Chosen.
There we go.
Will you take me with you when you go to give the goblins another thrashing?
Who are you exactly?
I used to be under Gort's command. We were even friends once, but I fell into a bed of mushrooms and gave him a good piece of my mind, you see.
So what is your name?
My name's Cawdor, but better call me Rowdy, like they all do. So think about it, you see. When it's time to fight, I am your man.
This guy's a fairly good voice actor, though, whoever does this guy.
Listen, the thing is, I promised somebody to help them with some, business. So I cannot leave the village right now. But when I am done, I would be happy to join your team.
There we go. And then, craftsman, he can build stuff. Silvertongue about the village, la 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 la, thank you. Captain Gort.
I am the captain.
What sort of trump you see?
So.
There we go. And then we go outside. Yeah, we can't really talk to anyone. Okay, so we go outside. Basically, what happens now is we have to... This is the world map. And this is the foothills here. So we have to go to the foothills. Yes. We have to kill a goblin sentry that is disrupting the village. Every time a villager leaves, the sentry goes and warns the goblins.
I concur.
And then they go, "Wah, get him!"
Aha. Uh-huh. Here's the goblin sentry.
Yo, bro, what's up?
Yes.
Okay, let's see if I can get to him without him seeing me. Okay. Turn. Turn more. Come on. Do I have to go around him?
Excellent.
I have to go around him. Let's go around him a bit. Watch, he'll turn to face me after I turn this way. Or after I go this way. Jeez, I don't know where his blind spot is.
Yes.
Oh, I got an idea here. Okay, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go up here, just at a site, I think. I'm going to wait, and then we're going to do the trick. Pause. Pause right here. Aim for his head, and then run at him. Because if you can get to them fast enough, even though you're making tons of noise and they'll normally see you and turn around, if you're fast enough, you'll still get a backstab multiplier. So here we go. Let's try it. Ayo, yeah.
Now let the goblins wait for the signals.
Now let the goblins wait for the signals. Yeah, that's right. Get deaded. Back to their village. And then it loads. There. And then we go back to this guy.
I am in your debt, Chosen.
There we go.
And I thank you on behalf of the other villagers, too.
Yeah, now they can...
I do not understand, Air Fox.
Now they can
get
their livestock.
But you talk as if you were about to lose your last pig.
It is not only goblins, but also wolves who attack our herd every night.
Do you expect me to run after miserable wolves? That is a job for a shepherd dog, not for me.
These wolves are far from miserable, Chosen. The pack who steals our pigs is no ordinary pack. And its leader, the White Wolf, is more cunning than any dog. How many times has he eluded our hunters? Only you, Chosen, can outwit that beast.
Yeah, because I'm the smartest one, definitely.
Your intelligence and cunning will give the White Wolf no chance at all.
Thanks.
I do not know of this dragon, Chosen.
Oh, yeah, in the opening cutscene, the main character sees a little, like, mini dragon fly to him, and then it flies away. He's like, oh, maybe this is the thing there. Also, I'm going to get a partner.
Ah, Chosen, what a dull life we lead. Not even a decent fight. No one to fight with here in this village.
All right, Rowdy, I have got something right up your street. You will like it.
Now you are talking. I will wait at the gates.
And just like that, now he's on your team. Creston's work.
Oh no, isn't that the Chosen?
He doesn't like you.
I suppose you're about to ask for something for nothing, are you not? Well, I will tell you this much. Whoever you are, you will get nothing free from me, so there.
Now listen to me. I need your services, not your bad temper.
I do not care what Chief Silvertongue told you. I never liked him anyway, and...
What stuff?
he doesn't like this guy. He's like... this guy goes like, oh, maybe you can go to the craftsman and get some stuff. And then you go this way, this guy is like, oh, I need your services. Like, I don't care what this guy told you. I can't make anything. My tools were stolen. So he's like, oh, go get my tools and I can bring you stuff. So out. And then what you can do is you can click camp. And then you can go here, and then you can see your character Zach, and we also have Rowdy. He has a bow, which is weird, because does he have the archery skill? He does have the archery skill. Okay, never mind. That's not so weird. He has a stone axe and a bow stonehead arrows. I'll explain how the crafting works when we get to that. Here? Oh yeah, we do have some experience to spend. Let's get 5 points in the melee skill. There, that'll increase our chances to hit. Your chance to hit is based off of your attack minus the enemy's defense, put into like a percentage, and then multiplied by some random number. It's weird. I'm not sure how it all works. Because it's like, well, let's say if I was attacking... I have 25 attack. If I was attacking someone with 15 defense, then it would be 25 subtract 15, which is 10, and then 10 gets put on a certain percentage chance to hit. And then I don't know what the scale is. And then it also goes through a random number generator for like a luck thing. It's really weird how it works, but it's like the more attack you have over their defense, the more likely you're going to hit them. So now we have two characters to command. If I press F1, yes, it'll be Zach. If I press F2, it'll be Cador. Or Rowdy, as it were.
Well,
so I can command
go.
Him to go. And I can command Zach to
I
go.
Concur.
And we're gonna save here as Miles the Man. I think we're gonna end this part here, but you can also do this.
Prepare to die.
And you can also just kill your teammates. And then he's gone. But you get all the stuff. But we're not gonna do that. Load. We're not doing that. So just as a thing, that's what you can do. It also counts as a backstab because he can't see me. If I go over here and I hit him, it's a lot harder to hit. Yeah. But if I go behind him, I get an automatic backstab critical. Bam. But we're not going to do that. We're going to keep him alive. So I'm going to exit to main menu. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you for the next episode. Next episode. Next episode.